First of all, let's have a look at the Everton lineup. The big shock, of course, that Fred Pickering is out. So Young will be at centre forward, and Trebilcock, who was signed only in December from Plymouth Argyle, gets in the cup final side after only a few months as an Everton player. That then the Everton team, which will be playing in the dark shirts, actually in blue. Now here's Sheffield Wednesday, and the man we all bite our fingernails for, Sam Ellis, number 5, and think of Vic Mobley, unfortunately injured in the semi-final, not able to turn up. Ellis playing only his 11th game for the club, but Pugh, the outside right, is even more inexperienced, but at least he has played in a cup tie. He played in the semi-final. Megson is the captain of Sheffield Wednesday, and here come the two teams, and it's Sheffield Wednesday on the right as we look at them. And now as we look at them, it's Sheffield Wednesday on the right, Alan Brown leading Sheffield Wednesday, Harry Kattrick leading Everton. Strangely enough, remember, Harry Kattrick used to be manager of Everton. And that's the view the players get. Behind the two teams, the three officials. The referee, Mr. Jack Taylor of Wolverhampton, his two linesmen, Mr. Morris of Kettering, Mr. Wallace of Swindon. There's Harry Kattrick. And this is now when the... There's Ron Springer, played here often for England. And this is the moment now when hearts go a-fluttering. There's Ray Wilson, another great England stalwart. And here's Alec Young, the fair-haired Alec Young, the late favourite of the Everton fans. Both teams looking extremely smart in their tracksuit. There's Jack Taylor, the referee from Wolverhampton. Two captains now meeting in the middle, and the referee, you notice, wearing the FIFA badge. That shows that he's an international referee. And there's the Sheffield Wednesday team, number 10. You can see Ford right in the middle. He's the chief goal scorer. The dispatch rider just walked in front of him, and that is Sam Ellis, and he's playing in centre half. Number 6, Young, the defensive wing halfback, is strong player, very fine player. And number, there's Megson, the captain. Number 11 is Quinn, and it's Everton who are going to kick off. Remember, Everton have reached Wembley, the first team ever to reach the cup final at Wembley without conceding a goal. Last time a team won the cup without conceding a goal was in 1903, when Bury beat Derby County 6-0. That, incidentally, is the biggest ever win in a cup final. Watches are checked. Young, Trebilcock on the far side, hands on hips, number 8 is Trebilcock on this side, on the far side of Harvey. And already Trebilcock, although wearing number 8, is in the inside left position. That's strange to see a Wembley final starting 2 minutes early. Don't expect miracles right at the start. This is when players can make mistakes. Feeling of this turf. This is Eustace, fine midfield player for Sheffield. Bowen, Scott, and here's Gabriel. And Kalliop coming back. Barling, Gabriel. Kalliop, fine wearing number 9 in the white shirt, but he's a midfield player, doesn't play an orthodox centre-forward game. Free kick going to be taken for Everton by Lapone. Gabriel Gabriel went in too strong, rather dangerously then. Referee having a word with him. Free kick. There's Jimmy Gabriel. Ron Springer, Wednesday goalkeeper. Teams who want to feel their way, probe to try and find any weak spot in the opposition. West finding Young, he's not a huge man, but can he climb up to a ball? Smith and Wilson quickly on the scene for Everton. Number six, Young. Fine Young moving upfield a great deal. Callio. Wednesday is Jim McCalliog, born in Scotland, of Irish parents. Signed from Chelsea. Corner taken by the outside right pew. McCalliog to Quinn. This is right. And again, Scott getting up to reach those high balls. Quinn. That's out of play, I think, yes. And are lining up with a back four of Wright, then the Bone, then Harris number six, then Wilson three. Oh, what's a good throw to four. McCalliog, a goal! And McCalliog has scored for Sheffield Wednesday in their number 84. His phantom rather. McCalliog's number nine, there he is, the man who got the goal that clinched the semi-final, has scored now after about 4 minutes play. So, Sheffield Wednesday lead, 1-0. Corner to Everton. Banter. Eustace. Now, Trebilcock. And Trebilcock is fouled by Eustace. Free kick to Everton. Number six is Harris. Harris to take the free kick for Everton. Eustace falling back to help covers the experience at the half. The spot. And taking the man. Free kick to Everton, going to be taken by Scott, and the tall LeBone has come up. Everton whipping everything into attack at the moment to try and get this equaliser. There's Springett. Young. Slipping Ellis, this is Young, he's got Treville Cock on his left. Ooh, Harvey. That lift brought down by the inside right of Sheffield Wednesday. Phantom. Ricket to Everton. Sheffield Wednesday tending at the moment to try and cover Young Ellis a wee bit too much in the middle. That's Quinn. Now Phantom taking over. Scott got back so deep because Bexham was breaking on the left. Wednesday. Lovely one from Harris to number 10 Harvey. Treville Cock. Young, now Gabriel. Proud record of not having conceded a goal in this season's competition lasted but 4.5 minutes of play. Phantom. By Harvey. Now Gabriel to Scott. Trebilko. Cornish viewer wrote to me and said his name was Treville Cock, but he says it's Trebilko. So let the player himself win. Bilko. And Harris. Left hard. Beautifully cut off by Eustace. Everyone was accusing Everton of being the defensive side, but they're coming forward all the time. Ten minutes of the first half gone. Throw to Everton, who trailed 1-0. Right. Surprise for the choices. And away now come Wednesday. This is Ford. Phantom there with him to Lucalio. Q. Wanted to turn ball, but Knight's with Quinn. And here's Temple, number 11 for Everton. Oh, a good ball to Young. Ellis caught in two minds then. Good tackle by Ellis. That's what he needed to calm any nerves he might be having. Why should you have nerves when you could get 10-0 levels and 3A levels in GCE? And here come Wednesday again. Eustace to Ford. Q. Yes, shirt outside his pants, behind his fullback, covering up. And Young, back to Temple. Bilko on his right. Mr. Bilko. Fine tackle by Smith, who's hurt. He's limping badly, the right back, Wilfred Smith, but quite happy to have stopped what looked a very probable goal. Now Quinn to Eustace. And a foul by right half Gabriel. And there's Phantom, the inside right of Sheffield Wednesday. And Smith has gone down again. So let's hope that it's not too serious an injury. And you can see where it is. There's the referee, Jack Taylor. There's Don Mixon, the skipper, already with a dry throat. And standing up on the right, number six, is Jerry Young, the left halfback. Coming across now to have a look is Alex Young. And Smith. All right. And where were we? It's a free kick to Sheffield Wednesday. And it's going to be taken by Eustace, the right halfback. And there's Smith, running quite well now. Bone. Now Young for Wednesday. Now Mixon. Here's Eustace for Wednesday. Gordon West, a Blackpool goalkeeper, a very expensive buy by Everton. Notice that Quinn, Tabby, just passed the ball and keeps playing deep for Wednesday. He wears number 11, but he's a midfield player. Right to Trebilko. And now Pugh coming back to challenge in midfield. Well, how's that for a player with very limited experience? And he gets caught out when he shouldn't have done. And this is Scott. He's got Young in the middle, Trebilko. And Kalliok. Now up comes Wilson. Young and no goal. He's offside. Young is offside. There's Alex Young. Second of glory suddenly fades away in the burst of the referee's whistle. Quarter of an hour gone and Sheffield Wednesday still lead 1-0. This is West, Everton goalkeeper. By Gabriel pushing Quinn in the back. Gabriel so over anxious, his side losing 1-0. Has Eustace to take the free kick for Sheffield Wednesday. Nettles tackled by Mixon, and Scott felt it, and Scott is injured. There's a spot of attention for Alex Scott, and the pattern of play now very apparent with, in the Wednesday defence, Ellis shadowing Young everywhere, and Young, number six, shadowing Trebilco. Up they go. Here comes Lebone, because number eight, Trebilco, and Wednesday, Young. And here's Quinn, not an outside left, despite the number 11 on his back. Now, Callio. Wednesday's thrown no evidence. Harris with the throw. Not quite knowing where to throw it. Throw to Chevy Wednesday, a foul throw. That was a good move. It's picked on by Ford. Number eight, Trebilco. Now Temple. This could be a good break by Everton. Back comes Eustace. Eustace had a fantastic match in the semi-final, and he's playing just as well in this game. And his Young onside, should be the equaliser. No penalty. It's a good decision. He fell right over the goalkeeper. Fell over the goalkeeper. Goal kick. And Young, Alex Young, expecting to see the referee pointing to the penalty spots. All he did was point for a goal. There's Wilson for Everton. Wilson once again, Everton have had a penalty appeal turned down, and a goal disallowed for offside. It's Gabriel. He's got Trebilco there. Wednesday, even though the defence might seem a little bit wobbly under pressure, can recover so quickly. Everton are only being given half chances. Wilson to Harvey. A good bit of football by Harvey and his Young, number nine. Whoops! Goal kick. Many international caps, but was never a cup winner's medal. Twenty minutes gone. Sheffield Wednesday still lead by 1-0. Number 11 is Temple. Number 3, Wilson. Nine, Young. And shadowed by McCallion. Young Pugh for Wednesday. Ford. Ford is the man who always wakes up field. And the few men doesn't play in midfield for Wednesday. Eustace. Eustace now to Phantom. And here comes McCallion. Lovely football. And Ford. McCallion's own men got in the way. Quinn. It looked very much as if goal number two was coming up, and the goalkeeper now, West, is hurt. He's on his feet, but he doesn't look too happy with life. The game goes on as Harris to Young. Hans Springer, very sportingly kicking the ball out so that attention can be brought on to the injured Everton goalkeeper, and the crowd, realizing what Springer did, applauding him for it. We don't often get that shot, do we? That's shot on the radio camera from right behind the goal being defended at the moment by Everton. Why don't you try those exercises first thing tomorrow morning? West all right again. Throw into Sheffield Wednesday, number six, Harris. The bone. Right. Yes, Ellis. Brains of Britain, the Sheffield Wednesday lads call him. I suppose all fathers in Sheffield now are saying to the sons, you work hard at your homework, get your O-levels, and you too might play in the cup final at Wembley. Of course, if you get 10, as Sam Ellis did, plus 3 A-levels. Smith. Ball. And it was hands by Phantom. Guided that ball. With his arm. There he is, Johnny Phantom, the great servant of the Wednesday club. Eustace. The bone towers over Ford, but we're still making the bone guard full stretch. Phantom. Quinn. Now Pugh. You wonder how it could happen until you get out there and it happens to you. Trevilco. Scott beginning to make the break, and he's got excellent speed. There's Alex Scott, Scottish international, outside right, signed from Rangers. Goal kick to Sheffield Wednesday. Throw to Wednesday. Makes his defence in the spot of bother, isn't it? Young. Beautiful. That's a real charm. Gabriel. Up comes Harvey. What better than that to beat Springer? 20 minutes left for play in the first half. 1-0 Sheffield Wednesday lead. Back. And notice who was challenging him, the number 11 of Sheffield Wednesday, Quinn. Blake now fouled by Harvey on Macalio. Free kick to Sheffield Wednesday. And this is Smith to take it. Macalio. And Phantom taking over. Oh, it's a corner. West wasn't very happy with that one. I think he knows it too. Sheffield Wednesday is playing some good stuff. Now it's Pugh to take the corner. fouled by Quinn. Free kick to Everton. I don't think it was quite there, was it? Number 8. And back comes Temple to help out Everton. Harvey to Gabriel. Oh, good bit of positional play by Harvey. Now to Scott. Gabriel back to reinforce the forwards. Sheffield Wednesday's quick to come back and pack in defence as soon as there's any danger at all to their goal. There's Pugh back. Jerry Young of Sheffield Wednesday, who's sapped his personality most on the game. Oh, very late tackle from behind by Bantham on right. There's Bantham on the right, and doing his gymnastics is Tommy Wright, Everton fullback. Free kick to Everton, and it's going to be taken by Scott. 10 Wednesday men back in defence. LeBone to Aitchung, and number 11 Quinn getting it away for Wednesday. And that's why Springett is one of England's top goalkeepers. Too soon then. So Smith, the very good fullback. And the ball must be over the line, not just on it. Kalliok to Paul. Anybody on the right wing? No. Made the mistake of carrying the ball too far then. Before it reaches Scott, paying the penalty, coming in late, giving away a free kick. There's Don Megson, the Wednesday captain, number 3. Quarter of an hour left for play in the first half. Sheffield Wednesday lead 1-0. Eustace moving it clear to Pugh. Eustace playing a splendid game. Gabriel to right. And McCallio taking over from Pugh. Ward versus LeBone in the dark shirt. Goal kick. And that's Trebilko on the far side, and Jerry Young of Sheffield Wednesday, both of them all right. Climb up to the ball, isn't it? Kayok to Pugh, and Quinn bobs up on the right wing. Bantham. He had to do something quickly as Gabriel came in to challenge. There's Bantham. Center of the screen. goal kick to Sheffield Wednesday, to Everton. Calliope is getting used to moving up. This is Ford. That is Eustace. Here he is. Both Bantam and Eustace then misjudged the pace of this Wembley turf. Next, Young behind him, Jerry Young. Bantam. Number 10, David Ford, who's the chief goal scorer of this Wednesday side. Local boy. Here comes Wednesday once again. This is Harvey, number 10, Everton. Trebilco. To find Young, but a good positioning by Ellis then. Right for Everton. Gabriel. Get out of the way, Red. Wilson. So Bilko, he's got Temple on the left, his Temple number 11. This is Derek Temple, England player. Smith, white shirt with him, goal kick to Sheffield Wednesday, who deservedly are in the lead 1-0. Thanks a good fluid start, the forwards are moving well and all coming back to play well in midfield and in defence. This is Bantam. To Pugh. Mixon. Quinn. Mixon. Most of the through balls usually seem to be going to the white shirts at the moment. Now Callio. Quinn. Mixon. It's Quinn again. 10 minutes left of the first half. 1-0 Sheffield Wednesday lead. Goal kick. Yes, Johnny Bantam. No, he wasn't outside the penalty area, so the ball wasn't in play. Back against fullback, and it's a throw to Sheffield Wednesday. Mixon looking round for the odd colleague, none around, so he's leaving the throw to Quinn, number 11. Outside, and that's not out of play. Scott. Bilko back now to Temple. It's Bacaliop chasing him. It's Gabriel. away from the Wednesday defenders, but it doesn't matter where Alex Young is, that's been over the line, a goal kick. And Eric Temple, they're cursing the Wembley ground staff. And here's Jim McCallion. Once again, Wednesday come with this most economical football that they're playing it very well. That's always the cue for someone to make perhaps the worst pass of the afternoon when I say that. To go, and it's a warm, close afternoon. There's having a bit of difficulty breathing, and could well have a great test of stamina before the end. Great danger that the team can run itself out if it's not careful. Now to Milko, and once again, Jerry Young, like a dart, as soon as he sees half a spark of danger. Smith for Wednesday. Eustace has gone down. Well, this is a blow to Sheffield Wednesday. They can't afford to be without Eustace. Jerry Young, Mixon, Phantom, and here's Q. Sheffield Wednesday fans to our right are singing "You'll Never Walk Alone." What on earth has that ever had anything to do with Sheffield? Liverpool fans will probably say it's sacrilege. So to Everton, that's Alex Young. Glutton's amount of work. Judged perfectly by Springer. Scott. And Jerry Young. Eustace. A moment or two. We saw go down. Injured. Seems all right again now. And here's Phantom. Eustace, seems all right again now, Peter Eustace. That's Phantom. Play on, says the referee. And here comes Eustace on the break. And a foul by Gabriel. Swatted by the referee. Obviously, Jack Taylor, the referee for Wolverhampton, having no truck with tackles like that. Number four on the white strip is Eustace. Free kick to Sheffield Wednesday. Phantom. Bad run from Mixon. Now here's Temple into Harvey. A well taken by Maxim. He was going the wrong way on the wrong foot. Supreme effort of balance there. Now Phantom. Using the 1-2 with McAleog, and again he used his hand. Free kick to Everton. 3 minutes before half time. 1-0, Sheffield Wednesday lead. That is McAleog waving Ellis back. He'll take charge in midfield. Gabriel at square with the Harvey and Wilson moving up. Here's Wilson. Again, Jerry Young brings the defence back superbly. Alec Young to Gabriel. Way break Wednesday, and this is Quinn. Phantom moving onto the right. Ford, Phantom now in the middle. Finish by Ford. But the 2-4-6 Everton men massed in the penalty area in front of their own goalkeeper. Almost half time now. No doubt the players will be thankful for the break. Warm and sultry here at Wembley. Harvey once again a lovely ball, this time to Harris. Harris is number six. This is Harvey. Now back where we started. Alex Young can still get him in the air, but there's nobody there to help him. Here's Quinn. This is Smith moving along the touchline. And here's Eustace. It looks as if Wednesday are going to go in for the half-time break, a goal to nil in the lead. This is Harvey, number 10 for Everton. Scott. Gabriel is up with Alex Young in the middle. Giblet so much into the Wednesday defence. Cover so well, tackled so keenly. There's Alex Scott. Number 9 is Alex Young. Here's Springett with a goal kick for Sheffield Wednesday, who lead 1-0. And it's almost now half time.
Played by Smith.
Sadly, Sheffield Wednesday not producing the sort of football that those people who call them a glamorous side would have expected. This is Quinn. He's looking around for his players to make space for themselves. And of course, Everton don't know whether they should come to the challenge or not. Ellis lucky to get away with that. Now, Quinn, who was second at go, we saw on this side of the pitch. There he is, in possession now to McAleog. Open strides, Eustace. Now, this is Harvey. Alex Young. Scott. No foul. No foul. So there we go, and it's Pugh. Eustace on his right. There's Eustace. Second one.
again, the economical game there, moving about in packs, so they can use the short form. There's always someone there to help the men in possession. Dobson back to Smith.
This is Jerry Young. Pivotally went to defence. Wednesday fans deciding to announce that it's also easy, easy, easy.
And the whistle goes for half-time. Everton 0, Sheffield Wednesday 1. The scorer of the goal in the fourth minute, Bukayo, and fine performance in this first half by Sheffield Wednesday. And as they go to the dressing room now, the players have to go through the Wednesday supporters and how happy they are. So, 1-0. Sheffield Wednesday lead. The goal scored after 4 minutes by their centre forward, Jim McCallion. Everton have really got to pull something out in the second half. Sheffield Wednesday have been playing very well indeed. More economical side, a more fluid side. Deservedly in the lead, 1-0. And there's no sign that they are a young, inexperienced team. And it's Sheffield Wednesday who start the second half. They're just 45 minutes away from glory. If they can hold out, and off we go. Notice that Bantham, the inside right, kicked off. All the days have gone when you had to kick off if you wore number 9. Remember what I said in the first half about the closeness of the atmosphere and the effect it can have on the players in the last few minutes. Now, in comes Alex Young, but this is number 2, Smith. That's a bad one. And Wilson now, Everton. How's that for a spot of coolness in the first minute of the second half of an FA Cup final? The Waistricks grab the ball. Sheffield Wednesday, Gabriel coming to him. And advance by West, tying to the Smith second. Quinn has done such a fine job of work. Back to his skipper, Mixon. Offside. Yes, he was offside. Bantham, he moved back and tried to look innocent, but he's been spotted by the linesman. Harris for Everton. Eustace, yes, Quinn again, this midfield player. Sheffield Wednesday. Phantom. And now Quinn appears in the position you'd expect to see him, and he's wearing number 11. Perhaps that was a good job that LeBone didn't have that one clear, because it might well have dropped straight to Phantom. Alex Young. And the speed of Alex Scott. And a fine tackle by Mixon. Something fantastic in this match. Players like Quinn and Eustace and Phantom. So they keep riding themselves with a spare man. Is Phantom, was it over the line? Yes, it was, before the goalkeeper touched it. The Wednesday running off the ball is so much better than Everton. That's why 9 times out of 10 Wednesday have the spare man. Foul by Smith on Temple. Free kick to Everton. This is Wilson to take the free kick. And it's Temple now. And lovely smiling photographer at the back must be a Sheffield fan, must he? Either that, or else he got a wonderful shot of that great save. Corner to Everton, Scott taking it. The hero of the moment, Ron Springett. Oh, a bad one from Wilson. Now Ford, he's got Pugh up with him.
Harris to save the day for Everton. This is Harvey, Everton midfield player.
Callio to Bantam. Up comes the skipper, Megson.
Number three, Dom Megson, will just give him an hour's extra centering practice tomorrow. Goal kick to Everton. And obviously West is not going to take goal kicks now because of this bandaged thigh, this strapped up thigh. It's the right back, right, taking it. Macalio. 5 minutes of the second half gone. 1-0 for Sheffield Wednesday. This is Harris. Back one and offside. And of course he wasn't offside when he dropped the ball, but that doesn't matter. It's where the player was when the ball was last played. Linesman in a perfect position there. Foul, Jerry Young using his arms to get a bit of extra height. Young, Alex Young to take the free kick to right. Wednesday players have to chase back in defence. Alan Brown, their manager, claimed they were the fittest side in football. And I don't think anyone will argue on their performance this afternoon. To Trebilko. And once again, Eustace there for Wednesday. And here's Jerry Young. Phantom to Eustace. Harvey with the throw. Obviously deciding that the foul had been committed by Quinn before his shirt was pulled out of his pants. Free kick to Everton. And Ford was 10 yards from the ball. So kick will have to be retaken by Brian Lebeau. Ooh, it's a good job you can't lip read anyway. If you can, you know what Brian Lebeau has just shouted to his colleagues. Bilko back to Harvey. Everton trying to get inside Bexley. There was a story going around that the Sheffield defenders were slow on the turn. Everton are picking away, trying to prove that they are. So far, Sheffield Wednesday's defenders haven't cooperated. Bilko, now Quinn. Oh, Phantom going away beautifully to Ford. Lovely bit of football by Phantom. Alex Young, Gabriel Harris, leaving it to each other. One or two examples of the Everton players not quite knowing who's going to do what, when. takes this throw. And who's going to take it? Mixon, number three. No. It's going to be Eustace. Alex Young, two. Gabriel. That's Quinn. Incredible where this fella Quinn bobs up. Now Ford to McCalliog. It's Quinn on the right, Ford in the middle, and Harris coming away with it. One and two of the Everton defenders now getting pretty carelessly, into looking as if they're leg weary. Start to be tired in under 10 minutes of the second half. You're facing a spot of trouble, especially when you're one down. Scott to Harris. That one broke well for Scott. 10 minutes of the second half gone. And Sheffield Wednesday coming away with it. Leading 1-0. And it's noticeable now, Gabriel is plodding along pretty much behind the players. If he's lost, and Harris too. Harris still hasn't got back in position. So both the Everton wing halves now looking very leg weary. And Kalliog! And it could well have been a second goal, because I think the first one seemed to me to be diverted. There's Jim Kalliog. Paddy, who said he was choked when he got the goal that clinched their semi-final victory against his old team, Chelsea. And Lebone has to take this goal kick because West decided that he's not fit enough to take it. Well, now Wednesday have got both Harris and Gabriel floundering, looking really leg-weary and very tired. That must be a wee bit grim for the Merseysiders. Young do it, no, and it's Phantom taking over. So well.
Oh, he's made a lovely move. It's going to be the second goal by Ford. A goal, and that should just about clinch it. As Wednesday's cup, it's Ford. Ford won in the fifth round, two in the sixth round. Johnny Phantom was the man who made that one. There's Walter Spotter, number 10. And they're the happy Sheffield Wednesday fans. And, well, the game goes on with Sheffield Wednesday leading 2-0. And how long have we had of the second half? About 12 minutes. Sheffield Wednesday are getting on top, playing the better football. They look the better side, and now Everton are definitely labouring. That charge of West must have made a great contribution to the comeback. And here's Alex Young. Harvey to Gabriel to Harris. Now a chance for Trebilco. He scored. So Trebilco has scored for Everton. 59 minutes of play. So we've got, what, 31 minutes left. And there the happy Everton fans. There's Temple, the man who flicked the ball to Trebilco. Trebilco, number 8, was the scorer. It's 2-1 for Sheffield Wednesday. Now they've got back into the game a bit. You should imagine that fresh heart will surge to the Everton players. Fresh air into their lungs. I think some pains of their tired limbs will begin to disappear a bit. This is Eustace to Quinn, to Pugh, to Eustace. Sheffield Wednesday just won't be ruffled out of their game. Oh, Eustace had moved up for that one. Gabriel to Trevilco. Harvey to Wright. This is Labone. Pugh. It's always been a good find by Alan Brown. What a thing to do when I say he's been a good find by Alan Brown. Still. Free kick to Everton. And we're now hearing the Mersey sound. Hardy. Oh, a beautiful one. That one would have got Scotland flying away with no defeat. But Mamex taking over the role of Springett. Oh, we've got just under the half hour to play. 2-1 as Scott takes the free kick. Everton. Players weren't 10 yards from the ball. It wasn't the hands of the referees given. They weren't 10 yards from the ball. Goal kick. You see Springer just taking his time about this one. He wants to calm things down. He knows that the impetus is with Everton at the moment. Just score. Callio. Callio to Nixon. This is Scott. Into Gabriel. Now to Wilco. Jerry Young has played such a great game. Four is Eustace and Palmer. Away comes Sheffield Wednesday. This is Johnny Quinn into Phantom. Now Gabriel. Bilko to find. Alex Young. Now it's with Temple. Scott calling for it. Jerry Young moving it away to number 9, McCallio. It's Quinn. There's Smith backing him up. This is Smith. Offside. Ford is offside. And here's the linesman right on the spot. Jim McCallio, scorer of the first goal. Alex Young. The other Alex taking over. Scott. And obstruction by Mex. An indirect free kick to Everton. Sheffield Wednesday have brought everybody back now. They have 11 men between the ball and their goal. Scott going to take it. There you see Harris moving up. Scott. Trevilco. A goal! He's equalized! supporters have raced onto the pitch and they've swamped in Tribilco. And their two supporters are going to see no more of this game. One of them thinks it's... And a great tackle, almost on the line. Almost on the line as that Everton supporter slipped his coat. As the phone probably telling the man to go quietly. And who's that? Harris, I think. Harris was wearing the policeman's helmet. And there's Mike Tribilco, a player for the modest Plymouth Argyle, not so long ago, now the scorer of two goals at Wembley, and two vital goals which have brought his team from 2-0 down to 2-2. And what a cup final this is turning out to be now. In what, about 4 or 5 minutes? Good. Well, they've won the cup for Everton. This is Alex Young. One moment, looking at the beaten side, Everton have picked themselves up off the floor. This is Harvey. Up comes Wilson. Derek Temple. So now we are midway through this second half, and a crowd over to the left. Those are the Everton fans. Well, no wonder. Two goals in 4 minutes have dragged their team right off the floor. Wednesday going to be great enough to dig their teeth in and come back. It's noticeable that two of the Sheffield Wednesday players are sitting down to rest during this stoppage. Nope. Don't blame anybody for sitting down now, because the atmosphere is completely electric. And Temple all right again. Up gets Ellis. Megson already on his feet. Springett can take the free kick. Sheffield Wednesday had 1.5 hands on the cup, but had that silver trophy snatched away from them. So the tip's really down now. Scott, Alex Young with him. Now to Gabriel. It's too far, I think. No, it's a throw-in. Throw to Sheffield Wednesday. This is Micallio. Everton ahead, they'll test of greatness. Passed it, there were two down, now they're two each. Now it's the test for Wednesday. Can they withstand such a bitter blow and come back? So to Everton. number 10 is Harvey.
Eustace.
Time we had extra time in the FA Cup final. We had extra time the year afterwards, and as we had extra time in the last final, I have to again. Oh, here's Alex Young. Up to. Minutes left for play and two goals each. And away now goes number 10 forward for Sheffield Wednesday. Goes Pugh. This is Phantom. Harris going across to take it. Mr. Wallace of Swindon was right on the spot. That was a foul. A foul by Smith. We get to Everton. For breath there. Calliope to Quinn. Number 7, Pugh. Comes Smith. Now Eustace. It's turned to fall back in defence, and now here's Smith. Good move. Rowan cutting it off, but you notice where number 8 Phantom was. Now Harris to Wilson. This is Harris. Without a doubt, the Everton players have moved far their strength now. Quinn into Phantom. Quinn once again. Phantom, noticeable. Space is harder to find at the moment for Sheffield Wednesday. Everton buzzing around with much more purpose than they were doing, covering the gaps, making it almost impossible for Wednesday to create space. And now a great chance of Memphis State by Jerry Young. It's Temple, and it's the third goal. Oh, what a tragedy for Jerry Young. There's Temple. Supporter racing onto the pitch. Whoa, there he goes. Calling his mates to come on with him. No tackle. Well, how stupid that these people should behave like this. Well, they probably think it's very clever, but they're certainly no credit to the great team that they support. So here we go with the kickoff, Sheffield Wednesday. Two up, now 3-2 down, and how long have we got left? 16 minutes left. And in 17 minutes we've had four goals. Performance this by Everton. And surprising now as one looks down from this lofty perch. On the right, complete silence. On the left, pandemonium where the Everton fans are. Cirilco into Alicchio. Cirilco is offside. We shall not be moved. Great to hear the crowd in such fine voice. What a pity just one or two of them have to spoil it all by running onto the pitch. Something that never used to happen at Wembley. Wednesday, that's going to be out. Well, you know who they support. Every one of them from Merseyside. This is Gabriel. Everton, a team who looked as if they'd shot the ball. Come back. Lead now, 3-2. Cirilco! Fantastic save by Springer. Now then, Sheffield Wednesday seem to be shattered and scattered by this incredible Everton comeback. Got to fling in everything now. This is Smith. And a free kick. A free kick. Foul on the goalkeeper. West by Phantom. Take the free kick. And the way streaks. Cirilco, he's got Young there with him. This is Young now. Alex Young taking over. Number 7, Scott. Temple, back to Wilson. Temple, the man who got that third goal. Here comes Harris. Kalliok. Phew. Good football by Wednesday. Here's Mikhailov. Oh, wait, star to see whether Wednesday could really pull out something sensational. Certainly need it now, but Everton, a team that has run on top, superb effort by the Merseyside. Now, of course, they can play with of the pressure lifted off them. 10 minutes from the end of this 1966 Cup Final. Everton lead 3-2. Scott and Gabriel coming up on the right. And the crowd's now warming up. What they feel will be just a rehearsal for the lap of honour in about 10 minutes' time. Scott to take the throw in for Everton. Gabriel. Now Quinn. Without a doubt, this has been a much better cup final than anybody forecast. Now Bantham. Now things that were going right for Sheffield Wednesday are now all going wrong. Free kick to Sheffield Wednesday. And Scott now being spoken to severely by the referee, Mr. Taylor. Young, all right. Jerry Young played a splendid game for Wednesday. And the Wednesday error after Ellis being caught out of position, which allowed Temple to go through for the third and what could well be the winning goal. And here comes Everton again. Harvey, Everton, Mr. Gabriel. Time of course is on Everton's side now. They play relaxed football. Keep possession of the ball. 8 minutes, they've got to keep this up. Now beginning to move around in packs as Wednesday did early on in the match. And Scott, can he reach it? No. My goodness, he nearly broke our radio camera. That would have cost him a bob or two more than the bonus you'll get for winning the cup. The sun really come out at Wembley now, shining brightly. And Eustace to Metzen now to Mikhailov. Now Pugh, put an awful lot of blue shirts between ball and the goal. And there's one of them, Gabriel, standing on no ceremony. Trevilko scorer of two of the three goals. Alex Young. And Scott and Gabriel going on the right. Callio.
It's a speed recovery of Luce, number three for Everton.
Back to Fenn. That's Johnny Phantom inside right. Sheffield Wednesday. Everton on the way to Wembley, have beaten Sunderland at home, Bedford Town away, Coventry at home, Manchester City after. In the second replay, always followed by this huge band of supporters. And now telling us very loudly that we shall not be moved. In the semi-final, Everton beat Manchester United. Wednesday, Quinn. Callio. Corner. Oh, the referee changed his mind. The linesman right on the spot. And who's hurt? I think someone among the cameras. It's Callio. Sheffield Wednesday on their way to the final. They played away all the time. Won at Reading, Newcastle United, Huddersfield Town, Blackburn, and beat Chelsea in the semi-final. Under 5 minutes left for play here at Wembley. Everton lead 3-2. A sensational comeback after being 2-0 down. This cup final that was written off, that was ignored by so many people. This cup final will surely be one to remember. Eustace McCallion. Goal kick. Goal kick to Everton. That's Ford on the edge of the area number 10. Everton, of course, not in any hurry. Fans now whistling as if they want that final whistle to go. By our watch, there are 3 minutes left for play. Maybe a spot of injury time as well. But this is Quinton now for Sheffield Wednesday. Oh, beautifully taken by West. Milko with his stockings rolled down, the sure sign of what a cramp. Not playing so badly, cramp or no cramp. Young, Alex Young. Scott, number 7, Scott. But play on, says the referee. Harvey getting up, realizing he's still breathing. Now Smith could climb up to that, but up goes Phantom. And Harris, the sport closes in. This is a real cliffhanger of a finish. Harvey, and that's Ellis, and Sam Ellis. I don't think I have ever seen so many policemen at Wembley before as are congregated behind the Everton goal, facing the Everton fans. Oh, I don't think there's a spare policeman for about 20 or 30 miles radius. What a pity that it's found so necessary to have so many.
Necessary, I'm afraid it is.
Ah, Eustace. Quinn, and up comes the fullback Smith. Up goes Eustace. Oh, what a goal that would have been from Phantom. Johnny Phantom, number 8. Eustace is hobbling away. Don't think we have any time for trainers now. The seconds ticking away. Looks now as if it's following the league championship to Merseyside. Scott. That's Gabriel. Again, you see Gabriel with his stockings rolled down. Gabriel, number 4. He's happy to play with it in that little area. He knows there can only be seconds to go. There can only be seconds left. And a corner. Right. What a real cliffhanger. Seconds from the end of the 1965 Cup Final. A corner to Chevy Wednesday, who were leading 2-0. 1966 Cup Final. So we can be a year out. 3-2. Every Wednesday down in their corner, everyone massing in the Everton penalty area. That was the fullback, Will Smith. And Smith, Will Smith, right back. And the crowd getting ready for the signal that Everton have won the cup. 3 goals in a glittering, glorious 15 minutes for Everton. Changed them from a beaten side to a cup-winning side. Terry Young. Callio. And Young has now collapsed. And it always feels worse, I should think, when you're losing. His attention has been called to Jerry Young, but he says play on. There's no time left. Everton have won. It's 3-2. A sensational cup final has been won by Everton. And Young has collapsed. He can hardly move, and Scott has come to have a look at him. The trainer goes on to Jerry Young. And the Everton player sportingly going to Sam Ellis to congratulate him. Fred Pickering, I can see. There's Fred Pickering, the man who was dropped. And Harry Catrick, the manager. What a fantastic comeback by this team. After 57 minutes, Wednesday got a second goal, and Everton were a beaten side. And then in 15 minutes, they came back with 3 tremendous goals, 2 by Trevilco, 1 by Temple. They've won the cup. But whoever said that this was going to be a bad final can now eat his words, because this has been a splendid match. And And the Sheffield Wednesday players lying down now, getting up. Alan Brown ordering them to get up, orders them to get up and cheer Sheffield, cheer Everton as they go to receive the trophy from Her Royal Highness Princess Margaret. Led by Brian Labone. And on the field to the sad figure of Vic Mobley, the Sheffield Wednesday star who couldn't play because of injury. Well, it's a good shade of odds that all the Everton players don't get up underneath that back slapping. There's LeBron, and there Her Royal Highness Princess Margaret with the cup. A great cup final. A fantastic comeback. And the medal for Skipper Brian LeBron, and there is the MA Cup. I got Montgomery at his congratulations. Gordon West, Ryan Harris, and Ray Wilson, Alex Scott, Alex Young, Jimmy Gable, who one moment looked jittered and now way back in the game. But as we pay tribute to the winners, let us not forget the gallant losers. And Don Nixon goes to receive his loser's medal. Ron Springett. Well, not long ago, these boys thought they were going to get winners' medals. How hard they tried for Calliog. Well, Sam Ellis, should have thought a few weeks ago, he'd have thought he'd have got any medal. Now, Jerry Young still must be suffering agonies. Finally, last but by no means least, Jack Taylor, the referee from Wolverhampton. Refereed so splendidly. And the two lines were Mr. Morris of Kettering and Mr. Wallace of Swindon. A superb final, magnificently controlled. And their Everton team, and I always feel sorry now for the Sheffield Wednesday team, will have to walk off after the national anthem. There's Harry Kattrick holding the cup. No, but they've not got the start yet. They've got the national anthems. They've got the national anthem first, before the lap of honour. It's Sheffield Wednesday are coming into the centre of the pitch. I think they too are going to do a lap of honour with Everton, and how well they deserve to. And there's the winners, and they're being followed for the first time that I can ever remember by the losers. And there we are, some fools will try to rush on. Why do they ruin it all? The crowd now are rising to Sheffield Wednesday as they come round. This, a great innovation after a wonderful final, but the losers should do a lap of honour. And sporting Wembley crowd rising to the losers as the Everton, there they are. How well they deserve the applause of the crowd. Right at the back, Jerry Young can hardly walk. But over to our left, pandemonium. And hardly bear to think of the fun and games there'll be in the city of Liverpool tomorrow night when Everton go home with the cup. Everton, the cup winners of 1966. Liverpool, the league champions of 1966. So it will be Europe coming to Merseyside with a vengeance next season. Holding the cup, Ryan LaBone on the left. Alex Young. And E.I. Adio, we've won the cup. There's Trebilco with his left hand on the cup. The two-goal man. Colin Harvey holding it now. Colin Harvey and Tommy Wright wanting to take over. And Ryan LaBone is taking over now to show it to these delirious fans. Well, a never to be forgotten final, this one. To be forgotten final. 4 minutes McAleog scores for Sheffield Wednesday. 57 minutes Ford makes it 2-0 and Everton are beaten. But then after 59 minutes Trebilco scores for Everton. 4 minutes later he scores again, and 16 minutes from the end Temple get the goal that took the cup to Merseyside. And even the sporting Sheffield Wednesday fans supporting the Everton team. There are some Everton players there, Everton supporters there, but mainly it's Sheffield Wednesday. But this has been a superb final. Everton winning the FA Cup for the first time in 33 years and for the third time in their career. They won in 1906, in 1933, and now in 1966. Three wins and three defeats in the FA Cup final for Everton. Today, a victory, a great victory. 3-2 over Sheffield Wednesday. Now into the dressing room, and no doubt the champagne. And how well they deserve the champagne for this almost unbelievable comeback. Any team, surely 2-0 down, can be thought to have lost the cup. And they were playing as if they'd lost as well. They looked laboured, they looked lost, and they looked as if it was all over. And then suddenly, whoosh, Everton hit Sheffield Wednesday with some sensational football, and in 15 never to be forgotten minutes, turned the game round and won 3-2.